If you have subscribed to my channel, please press the subscribe button to help me grow my channel and for more videos. As you can tell my outfit, I'm dressing up as Luna Lovegood. Even got her reddish earring and her wand. And today we're going to the Warner Brothers studio tour to see Hogwarts in the snow. And this is my fifth time going. And now we need to catch the Hogwarts Express. And let's go! Here, so excited. It took us 3 hours, maybe 3.5 to get here. It's quite cold. It's just gonna change into my robe when I get in. Let's go. Thank you.
Great Hall. Now, this is one of our largest and oldest sets that we have here at the studio tour. It stood in a soundstage, to my right, for about 10 years before it was bought back piece by precious piece for the studio tour. Now, I'm sure you've noticed that we are decorated for the Christmas feast that you would have seen in Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone. We've got this sumptuous feast laid out and all these gorgeous Christmas trees lining the Great Hall. Now, the Christmas trees were a bit of a joint effort. They were designed by the art department, they were built by the props team, and even the special effects team headed by John Richardson got involved, and they made these malevolent fairies you can see circling the tops of the trees. Now, back to this feast. Now, originally, they used real food during filming, and you can imagine that when they came down in the morning, that smelled amazing, lots of roast turkey vegetables. Well, that lasted for about 2 hours, because obviously the cost of the lights, let's just say the food started to smell less than appetizing. They made the decision to switch to baked food, and that's what you can see in front of you now. It's made out of resin, all except for the peas, which are actually full bearings covered in green spray paint, so you definitely wouldn't want to try those. Now, but all that food you can see is on your right, but if you look over to your left, you'll see puddings. And what Christmas feast is complete without a Christmas pudding? Now, we have put together a bit of a surprise for you during our Hogwarts in the Snow feature. If you'd like to wander over to the lovely Lauren who is waving at you, we have a little bit of a treat for you. So if you can line all the way down the length of the wall there, just so you're a bit spread out. And if I can ask you to take one step behind the barrier, just one step back for me, that's it. I'm going to say to Lauren, 3, 2, 1. Look at that, guys. Flaming Christmas puddings. Now, they do look amazing, but you wouldn't want to eat them. They're made of solid cement. So, just as Ron, Harry and Hermione did, you came through the doors, down the centre aisle, and you would have carried on all the way down to the top end of the Great Hall. So if you'd like to follow me all the way down to the top hall, top of the hall here, you can see the teacher's table, where Harry, Ron and Hermione would have been sorted into their houses by some of Britain's leading acting talent. Now I'm going to share with you our first behind the tour secret of the day. If you take your eyes over to the right, you will see the impressive costume of Rubius Hagrid, played by the amazing actor Robbie Coltrane. But the secret I'm going to share with you is that Robbie Coltrane never actually wore this outfit. Now, he was a tall gentleman at 6'2", the same height as Professor Snape next to him there, but certainly not tall enough to be classed as a half giant. And so a size double was used in the form of Martin Mayfield, who's an ex-England rugby player. He was 6'10". Much taller, but still not tall enough to be a half giant. So stilts were added to his shoes, his robes were bulked out, and a large animatronic head that looks like Robbie Coltrane was added. And you can actually see this head working in the creature section a bit later on. Unfortunately, that does bring us to the end of our time here in the Great Hall, but I've got a few things just to share with you before you make your way on. If you have the blue studio tour passports, you are looking for 7 stamps and 16 golden stitches, which are hidden around the tour. The first one I'll give you for free is just under the archway over to your left there, but you need to find the other 15 for yourselves. If you have the audio guide with the green...
Thank you.
are just stopping for lunch.
This is a chicken burger. And obviously a butter bean.
It actually just tastes like butterscotch. Quite sweet.
Thank you.
you have enjoyed the studio tour as much as I did. Although I've been a few times, I still really enjoy it, and also every time I go, I always find something new. And also I have filmed the studio tour shop. I'm gonna put it on a separate video, so please subscribe to my channel so you won't miss the video. So thanks for watching, bye!